tip of the tongue. How many cases did we solve until now?
Phelps,
I don't even know anymore.
B-Cop says he located a green Kaiser Frazier from the hot sheet. The address is 6 West 2nd Street. Get over there and see what you can find out. Go on. Sorry to inconvenience you.
We're on it, Captain.
I didn't really understand anything about...
I swear, the more bent cars we bring in, the longer the hot sheet gets.
It pays the rent, though. Keeps Mrs. Phelps in the manner to which she's accustomed.
I'm not sure she'd agree with you.
Passionate, romantic type like you, Cole? I don't believe a word.
Isn't he the cop that won the medal in his...
I don't understand anything in this game anymore. What exactly is our job right now? Come on, partner. Move your bum. Can drive like a drunk. Because, yeah, that was probably...
They're calling her the Dahlia now. Wonder what Veronica Lake makes of that one.
You hear whether they're making any progress?
But Captain Donnelly seems to think they have it all wrapped up. Brown and Green are...
Oh, those graphics again.
I heard it'll be in front of the grand jury by next week.
Whoop. Out of my way.
Terrible enough being murdered like that.
Out of my way. Oh, flying cars. Great. Show me the road, please. Whoa. Whoa. It is kind of a funny episode. Dealing with here.
That's the car, Cole. Just pulling out of the drive. Get it.
Why didn't we get out of the car in the first place?
Remember, we need him healthy enough to answer questions.
I can do that. I'm the best at crashing cars.
Phelps, requesting immediate backup in pursuit of a stolen green Kaiser Frazier from 6 West 2nd.
So the Kaiser Frazier is the name of the car. That explains quite a lot.
Lay into his wheel arches. Come on.
So he kind of... Oh, come on. I was thinking he basically knocked himself out there, but nope. No dice.
Enough games, Phelps. Take this guy out.
You want to drive? Look, his car is totally wrecked, but he's still not giving up. So,
Alright, alright. Maybe I was a couple miles over the speed limit.
Now!
Probably.
Get brakes out of the car now!
I'll call it in.
What's, okay.
Show me your hands! Why did you run from us?
I saw a big car in my rearview mirror with two tough guys bearing down on me. What would you do?
What's your name?
Cliff Harrison.
You're under arrest.
For what? What are you talking about?
For wrecking the city, maybe?
I'm talking about the car being stolen.
You're out of your mind. I bought the car, and I've got the paperwork to prove it.
Doesn't change anything with the fact that you destroyed the city, but...
We'll have some questions for the people at Coombs Automotive.
Okay, Kaiser Frazier. Well, anyway, the car is in not a good condition right now. So
you purchased this car from Coombs Automotive Company?
Yeah, that's right.
Is this guy an honest guy? I'm not quite sure.
And the ownership papers?
From the same place!
Could have showed me them in the first place.
If this is a forgery, it's top notch. This will need to be traced.
Well, this looks right.
You have a criminal record, Mr. Harrison?
No, nothing like that.
Really? Show me your facial expressions. No, I doubt it.
You better give us something, Cliff. Or we're gonna make this hard on you.
I didn't steal the car. I ran because I've got some wacky-backy in the glove compartment.
How much, Cliff?
One reefer.
We'll let it slide. You're in enough trouble.
Okay.
Who did you deal with at Coombs Automotive?
The owner, Richard Coombs.
So we're gonna talk to that guy.
And he made out the bill of sale, personally?
Of course he did. He kept a facsimile for his records. Check with him.
I'm gonna do that.
We're going to get to the bottom of this, Harrison. Until we do, you're going downtown.
You gotta be kidding me! I'm getting arrested for buying a goddamn car?
If everything is legit, Harrison, you'll be out soon. Until then, if I were you, I'd keep my mouth shut.
Bag his possessions as evidence, and have him arraigned for Grand Theft Auto.
Right, Detective.
You know who my father is!
We need to get to Coombs Auto and check out Harrison's story.
Oh yeah, that netted me an achievement. It's always nice.
It was.
I think he's telling the truth.
Some of the most convincing people you will ever listen to are born liars. Usually they're called politicians.
Another usable favorite. Brought to you by Bullseye Brands.
Paperwork all looked above board, and he seemed
driving
like a
on the wrong lane. Like a mouse.
Well, I get it now. You see some kid who's basically you 5 years ago and assume he's gotta be innocent.
I'm more than happy to be proved wrong.
Hey, if he'd been black or Hispanic, you'd be singing a different tune. You spout all this communist crap about treating everybody the same, but it only works one way.
Whoa. I'm not sure that's communism,
Stefan. Oh, my God, please. Not another history lesson from the man who single-handedly won the war.
What's his problem?
Yes, I feel much better. We'll shake down the car dealer and take it from there. Unless his daddy plays golf with yours, of course. In which case, we'll give him a firm gentleman's handshake and be on our way.
See? I knew you weren't finished.
But still, those two guys, they kind of get along with each other. But they kind of hate each other as well, so. Sure where to go there. I think the graphics haven't loaded as well yet. Look, the graphics are popping in. This is from time to time this whole game is a bit ridiculous.
Not another step. I have got a Buick Century sedan that would be absolutely perfect for you.
Is this the same guy that I don't think so. Well, what I wanted to say is that the game can have super awesome graphics, but not all of the time. So and it's
Phelps,
tanking my
LAPD,
frame rate for what?
Owner? That's right. Richard Coombs at your service. You looking to trade in a black and white, boys?
Mr. Coombs, we're investigating an auto theft. A man by the name of Cliff Harrison claims he bought the car here.
Well, some people would say that my cars are a steal. That's a joke, son.
Very amusing, Mr. Coombs.
I remember Harrison. It was a green two-tone Kaiser Fraser, if I remember rightly.
Do you have the bill of sale?
It's in my office. Walk this way. That's a joke too, son.
What's up with this guy?
Do you mind if I shoot this guy? He's getting on my nerves.
Thank you so much.
Here it is. Got the original pink slip there, too.
Okay.
Gene Archer. 146 North Fremont Avenue.
That's someone else. So there's the signature. What about this?
Harrison's purchase receipt was legit, at least.
Yeah. But the Jean woman is...
We have a couple of questions.
All right, fellas. Shoot.
Can you tell us how you came to buy the car?
Girl just wandered in right off the street.
Nothing unusual about the car?
Not really my usual type of vehicle. The price was certainly right, though. Nice girl, but about as sharp as a bag of wet mice.
Did you pay with check or cash?
A check. She wanted it made out to cash, but I insisted. Man has to watch his cash flow.
What name?
I made it out to Gene Archer on the Bank of Arcadia.
Okay. Guess we're gonna have to talk to her after we're finished with Mr. Coombs.
Can you describe this Gene Archer?
Brunette, maybe 25, 26. A little on the plump side, but not bone ugly.
I guess he's telling the truth. Why would he lie about her appearance?
What was your impression of her?
Kind of harried and harassed. In a hurry to go somewhere, but no place to go. You get to know the type.
Do you know anything about the company that prints these pink slips?
Nope. Should I? It isn't exactly my business.
It says Marquee Printing. You've never heard of them?
Marquee. Sure. They do all the government red tape. You'll find the place down on Aliso Street near San Pedro.
Well, I wouldn't have thought about asking about the producer of the paper.
When exactly whatever. Did you hand over the check, Mr. Combs?
Close of play on Friday.
Nope.
Why didn't you pay her cash? You knew the car was dirty.
I had an inkling. When people are in a hurry for money, always pay by check, son. Gives you a couple days to back out.
This was all above board.
Yes, of course it was.
Nope, it wasn't.
Did this look legitimate to you, Coombs?
I'm in used cars, son, not bearer bonds. In my business, you don't look a gift horse in the mouth. Now don't come on all high and mighty with me if you want my help.
Thanks for your help, Mr. Coombs. We need to continue the investigation.
And we rock this.
Hope you sort out your problem with Mr. Harrison. Go easy on him, son. Boy's about as sharp as a bowling ball. He's built too low. The fastballs fly over his head.
Let me shoot this guy, please. You have a pleasant
Go
day.
Go ahead. But still, that was rather
Harrison
helpful.
Might be off the hook, but we can still run an APB on Gene Archer. Get on the horn and call it in.
Gonna do that. I was kind of worried that I wouldn't get over this fence because sometimes games are stupid like that.
Phelps, badge 1247.
How could I help, Detective?
Requesting an APB on Gene Archer, age approximately 25, on suspicion of Grand Theft Auto.
I'll relay the information.
Messages for me, please.
A James Velasco is being held at Central Station on suspicion of GTA. Possible link to the Harrison case. They're waiting on you to conduct the interview.
Thanks.
Okay. Where are we gonna go first now?
You're behind the wheel. And where exactly are we going?
Let's go to the police station first. Maybe. No, let's do it from top to the bottom. Even though... Nah, we're gonna go to the police station. I don't even know.
Here's a chicken and egg question for you. Do you think you have to be an asshole to sell cars? Or that selling cars turns you into an asshole?
You've got it in for everyone today, haven't you?
I've always got it in for car sales. It doesn't matter what they are. And why do they always think they're comedians when they're about as funny as a heart attack?
Maybe the more annoying they are, the quicker you sign on the dotted line just to get the hell out of there.
That would make sense.
Detectives, Belasco is prepped and ready in two. Another stolen car with legit papers.
Thanks.
I think okay. We bust in there and find the goddamn evidence.
In two? Where exactly is two?
Somewhere.
Oh, look, I don't know my way around this department. I don't know. Interview room two. It's not this one. It's this one. All right.
Crummy bastard.
Get in here, partner.
James Belasco?
I want a lawyer. It's my car and I got the proof right here. Take a look for yourself.
Okay.
The paper is real enough, Belasco, but the car isn't yours. This pink slip is a forgery.
Straight through the
okay.
Bet you never saw it.
Nothing written on here. How do we know it's a forgery?
He ran the letter on Olympics. We finally.
Where were you taking the car, James?
Blow it off, greenhorn. You'll get nothing from me.
What's up with him?
You're a two-time loser. If you don't give me something, I'm gonna ask the DA for the maximum. You're looking at 10 years, Belasco. Kiss your youth goodbye.
I want a deal.
Keep talking and we'll see what sort of deal you're worth.
My job is to drive the cars out of state. Nevada, Arizona, sometimes New Mexico. With the paperwork they provide, it's normally a breeze.
Does the name Gene Archer mean anything to you?
Nope. Never heard of her.
Gotta doubt that.
Do you have a partner here to convince you that you do know her?
I'm giving you the straight dope. I don't know no Gene Archer.
I thought it was worth a try.
What happens to the cars once they cross over the state lines?
I don't know. I just deliver them.
I doubt that as well.
Give me something, Belasco, or I'll take you back to the cells and tell the whole station you're a child molester. How long do you think you'll last?
Ooh.
Okay. I hear you. The cars get sold in Chicago or back east. Sometimes I bring back cars coming the other way.
See?
Where do you pick up the cars, Belasco?
Warehouses. Mainly in East downtown.
Guess that's the truth.
Come on, Belasco. You must have an address.
That's not the way they work. They keep moving around. Never the same address twice.
You had a chance to cooperate, Belasco. See you in 10 years when you get out.
Well, that was unfortunate
Phelps,
for both
right?
of us.
Yes, I am. Look. Can we do this later? I'm in the middle of it.
Ray Pinker. I'm with Technical Services. The pink slips are all real.
Yes, we know that.
There's only one company that prints them in California, the Marquee Printing Company. They've confirmed that the numbers are legitimate.
You've checked them out?
Sure. They're on Aliso Street near the corner of San Pedro. The guy I spoke to was Lightfall. Gordon Lightfall. Here. I wrote it down.
Thanks, Ray. This is a great lead. We'll get down there as soon as we can.
Okay. How come this guy helps us?
door knocking all morning.
Your GTA suspect, Gene Archer, spotted by a patrolman. Western Union office, 253 South Hill. Less than a minute away down the street if you run.
Okay.
No! She won't hang around.
Keep your cool. I guess we're gonna go there now. Partner! Move it! Come on!
Don't wanna lose her!
Look, it's not my fault that this car can't turn properly.
Can we try to get there in one piece?
So, is she on foot or going by car?
It'll only take a little while longer, madam. It's quite a lot of money.
LAPD.
Seems like a nice boy.
We'll take it from here.
God damn it.
Hoodlums in jail.
Everyone's against me. Look, just let me get my money and get out of here, okay?
Nope.
You look sweet. How about giving a girl a break? I could be very nice.
I'm afraid I can't do that, Miss Archer. Stefan, call for black and white.
Just my luck to get the only hair sure cop in the LAPD.
Well, she's not that pretty, is she?
The car you sold maybe it's just was stolen, Miss Archer. There won't be any.
I just don't like her.
I handed over all the right paperwork when I sold it, Buster.
Everything about this woman is weird. Look, I haven't used my intuition in quite some time, and I really have to do this. I'm gonna ask the community. We doubt her.
Gene, you've blown open the whole operation because you were dumb enough to try to sell one of the cars. What do you think they're gonna do to you? Give me something.
I was just doing what they do. They pay me $50 to drive the car. I made $2,000 selling it.
You made zero. And if they catch you, you're dead. Is that all your life's worth?
Look, a girl needs things. I don't see you looking out for me.
How long have you and Belasco been delivering cars?
Who is James Belasco?
Yeah, of course.
He's your boyfriend.
Oh, yeah.
The guy you boost cars with. He gave you up. He thinks you're so dumb you'd steal a free sample.
So I'm no genius. I make the best with what I've got. Why are you so cruel?
That's kind of my job.
You decided to make this hard on yourself, Gene. Let's see how you handle the hard time.
But I don't like... I mean, I knew that she was not telling the truth. I still think the line is super blurry sometimes between doubting someone and accusing them of lying because... Well... Yeah, I was too. I made a rash decision there. That's how it goes sometimes. There was a lot of interaction in a short period of time. We're gonna go now. Let's finally go to that printing company. I cannot really imagine what interesting things they might tell us, but I guess we're gonna find out.
Friendly girl.
Used to getting her own way.
Little did she know her feminine charms were useless against the impenetrable Cole Phelps.
She's not my type.
What is your type, Phelps?
I'm married.
I know that. But you're not blind or dead inside, are you? Wait, scrap that second half of the question.
I don't know. Blondes, I guess.
Hallelujah! The man is human after all. Now we're getting something. Yep, I'm with you on the blondes. Brunettes are fine too. There's nothing wrong with a good redhead. But I draw the line at gray. You know, I might have to lift that embargo soon in the interest of maintaining a free market.
A man with high standards.
The standards are only as high as the last glass of whiskey.
I like my partner. I really like him.
I am shots fired off speed help. Chateau and Valencia, shots fired off
street,
unit to have
deal with it, you police officers, you know how to shoot back.
City. Plus, I guarantee that I'll...
Since
taking the other phones free for the weekend.
Okay. We're looking for Mr. Lightfall, right? Is there something to... No, not really.
And what can I do for you, gentlemen?
Answer
some
questions, hopefully.
I'm a traffic detective from Central Division. Who's in charge here?
I am, Gordon Lightfall. What's this about?
We understand that your company prints California vehicle titles.
Yes, I have the government contract to print pink slips. I've done for some years.
Have you had any goods or equipment stolen recently? We're running up against stolen cars with seemingly legitimate paperwork.
Not recently. Have you ruled out forgery? There's no shortage of talented artists in this town.
We'll keep it in mind.
Is that everything? I kind of don't think so. Let's talk a bit more.
We have some questions for you, Mr. Lightfall. Mr. Lightfall, we're currently working two auto theft cases. Do you know anything about a car theft ring?
Certainly not. Why would I get mixed up in a thing like that?
He seems a bit nervous, right? And he's looking down? I doubt him.
We have suspects with legitimate pink slips that were printed here, Lightfall. You better give me something before I bring the whole department down here.
Don't be hysterical, detective. As a matter of fact, we had a similar problem a couple of years ago. A number of used car lots were selling blank documents to a criminal organization.
Okay.
Do the names Cliff Harrison and James Belasco mean anything to you?
No, they do not.
Are you probably telling the truth? Look how he looked to the side. Saw that? I doubt... I could use my... No, I'm not using up my intuition.
Harrison bought his car from Coombs. The pink slip looks good, and that points the finger here. Do you have any employee trouble?
No, I don't. They've all been carefully screened. Look, now that I think about it, the name Coombs sounds familiar. I think they may have been involved in stolen documents in the past.
Okay.
Do you have a delivery ledger, Mr. Lightfall? We would like to cross-check against the Coombs Automotive Emporium.
It's a little out of the ordinary, Detective. I'm not sure I can share those sorts of records.
You can. Gotta watch this expression.
Hand it over, Lightfall. You don't want us having bad thoughts about you, do you?
Very well, but this really is irregular. Over here.
Look for patterns, recurring names, unusual addresses, anything out of the ordinary.
Okay. Order of pink slip things, I guess. Address S before is, Folk Publishing. This S before address thing looks strange to me. But they are too large, 10 large, too large, 10 small. And, all right, and most of these guys were, you see with the red ink, I can tap this, as before.
You certainly encourage repeat business, Lightbulb. This Mr. Bigelow is a good customer. Sorry to bother you, sir. We'll let you know if there are any developments.
Okay, maybe I just didn't understand what I was supposed to understand. Are we done here? I'm not really sure if we're done. but I think the game suggests that I'm done. Go to the industrial street, large warehouse. Maybe we'll find something just there. That building.
Citizen reports a 211 in progress. 437 East 8th Street. Unit to handle code 3 identified.
Well, that's far away. I guess it really is that large building you can see on the horizon. It's also suspicious because it's already rendered in and not popping up like the rest of the city is. What did I tell you? I guess my partner will do the driving after this, because the game cuts it shorter that way. Oh, this seems to be...
Get Fleischer down here. I thought you Marines were gung-ho, Cole. You have a 45, don't you ever want to use it? I'll take the back. Just give me a few seconds to get around there.
I really don't want my partner to get hurt, but I have a bad feeling about this.
Cole Phelps, LAPD. All of you are coming downtown with me.
that certainly help. Oh, maybe I should. Whoa. Okay, that's one down.
It's the electric chair.
Okay, this.
Covering fire!
I barely see anyone. Look, man. Reload. Wow. Does that guy have an automatic gun? That's one down. This is getting really out of hand. Whoa! I think we've been hit. Yeah, reload. Wow! And that guy... Whoa! What did just explode there? I really have to... Okay, maybe I can hit them better from this position. I almost hit him there. Okay, that's another one down. I think my partner's got one as well. It's really hard to see those guys. Alright. I guess we're almost done here now.
Clear the top floor. I don't want to get drilled in the back on the way out.
Okay.
Just
stay down.
Whoa. Ah, reload.
Stay in cover.
Almost had him. Can I shoot through there? Not really. Whoop.
Try the door at the end. I heard something.
Can I reload, please? So for some reason, I cannot reload. Press A to pick up a weapon? No. I'll stick with my pistol. I like it.
All right! Don't shoot! Keep your hands up. Watch him, Bukowski. He doesn't move until I've tossed this place.
Can I, no. Wow. That was intense.
Marquee Printing Company. There's nothing like going direct to the source.
Yep.
Betting slip. Looks like Mr. Lightfall has been on a losing streak.
Well. That is definitely interesting. Is there something else to find? The pink slips. Of course.
There are slips here to keep them stealing cars till Christmas. We've got a trail of pink slips and stolen cars that leads right to your door, Bigelow. You're in this up to your neck, but I don't think you're the man in charge. Make it easier on yourself. Give him up.
I had to work on cars for customers. You charge in here shooting up the place like it's the Ballad of Bulge. I can't give you anything.
What about that pink slip supply?
You can make this easier on yourself by giving us your man on the inside.
I sometimes repair cars and put them back on the road. I need a pink slip to resell them. There's no problem there.
There is?
There are at least 4 dead men in this warehouse. A couple more. Punks won't make for that much extra paperwork. We'd be doing the legal system a favor.
Okay, tough guy. I get the message. Lightfall. The guy who runs Marquee. He's the big shot.
Of course.
He likes to spend big at the track. He owes people.
Lightfall, the guy with no luck at the track. Tell me about him.
It's one of the guys lying over there. You're right. He has no luck.
That was bad, man. That was really bad.
That's the best lie you can come up with, Bigelow?
Hey, would I lie to you, Detective? I'm not exactly in a good position here now, am I?
It's like, I mean, although I'm not quite sure what to choose now. I just, I'm really not sure.
No proof, huh?
No.
Looks like your mouth moves faster than your little pencil.
Whether you give up your bosses or not, Bigelow, you're going away for as long as I can put you there.
We'll see. I didn't fire a shot, copper. I just watched you tear my place up.
That didn't went too well. Pretty bad at talking with people. But I guess we're gonna talk to the real Lightfall now.
Cop,
the boss of the Marquee Printing Company. I actually wanted my partner to drive, so...
You can drive. So, where you want to go?
Back to the printing company, I guess.
What a mess.
Gonna take some cleaning up, that's for sure.
I wish it hadn't gone that way.
Well, we shouldn't bring guns to work with them.
We didn't have a lot of choice.
You have to admire the barefaced cheek of someone who tries to blow your brains out one minute and pleads innocence the next.
Yeah, especially when he's surrounded by evidence. If guys like Bigelow spend so much time convincing themselves that they're not doing anything wrong, that they actually start to believe their own bullshit.
They get sloppy. Bigelow, Lightball, all of them. If they hadn't, who knows how long they could have kept this racket going.
Complacency or greed. It's always one of the two that brings them down.
True enough. Let's see what happens. Ah, don't run against the wall.
You're under arrest.
You again? This harassment is starting to wear thin.
Ah.
We found a box of pink slips in a warehouse full of hot cars. You signed for them, Lightball.
I signed for all the orders and deliveries. You'll need something better than that, cowboy.
Oh, God. I don't need my intuition.
Save it, Lightball. We already have all we need to send you down.
I've had enough of this. You either produce some shred of proof, or I call my attorney.
I should have used my intuition on this. That's actually possible. But, well, look, we have the gambling debts.
You're in the hole with the organization.
Yep.
We know about the debts, Lightball.
I agree. I have a small problem. I'm prepared to help you in any way I can, Detective.
Oh, suddenly.
I'll name names. I need you to keep this out of the paper.
You need to shut up now, Lightball. Gordon Lightball, I'm charging you with conspiracy and fraud. Hands behind your back.
The LAPD Central Traffic Division has today smashed a nationwide auto theft ring, writes crime correspondent, blah, blah, blah. Oh, here it is. Traffic squad detectives confronted a large group of armed thugs. After an exchange of gunfire, more than a dozen dead criminals were removed from the scene. The LAPD sustained no casualties. Damn fine work, folks.
I like how this guy is so enthusiastic with us all the time.
I want to finish reading this.
I guess that was a good day's work. And we didn't demolish the whole city this time. That was cool.
My family runs a shipping business in San Francisco. We used to have two ships a week to Tokyo. We've been in shipping for two generations, Hank. I've never been on a voyage anywhere. I feel like Odysseus in the beginning of his journey.
The Odyssey took 10 years, Cole.
This is the American century. America can rule the world after we win this war.
We need to stay alive, Cole. These men are counting on us. Have you heard what the veterans are saying to each other?
No.
Golden Gate in 48. That's four more hard years of fighting.